Chaotic scenes at testing clinics have forced South Australia to scrap swabs for interstate arrivals who aren't already showing symptoms of COVID. The decision to concentrate on the danger within the state comes as cases surged again. Alan Murrell joins us now. Alan, how many positive tests now?
Well, Jennifer, there were 154 new COVID cases in South Australia. 134 of those are locally acquired, so significantly 87% of transmission has been in the South Australian community. We can tell you that two of those are cricket fans who were at Adelaide Oval for the test. SA Health is looking into whether there are any other close contacts. 17,933 tests were carried out. Something had to give. The state government decided there was no point anymore in testing thousands of interstate arrivals who already have a negative result. Instead, they're focusing on finding the South Australians out there who are contracting the ever-spreading COVID. We have seen the test waiting times at places like this at Victoria Park fall significantly. It's down to an hour and a half now, but that's far different scene to what it was hours ago.
The wait for tests was driving thousands seeking swabs around the bend throughout the night. The wait blew out to 9 hours at Victoria Park, spilling way down Fullerton Road. At Adelaide Airport, emotions ran high. People had earlier been turned away and told to go elsewhere.
Big queue, 11:30, they said that's it. We have to go home and we have to come back here again.
Some drove from site to site, only to find themselves stuck in a different queue.
Didn't stop at Tailand Bend, which was foolish. It was only 4 hours there. And Narracourt would have been about half an hour. So, you know, I think there are better ways of doing this, I'm sure.
Finally, this morning, the government realised the system wasn't working.
Everybody arrived at the same position pretty much at exactly the same time.
The requirement for a test on arrival and day six for interstate travellers was dumped immediately. The announcement at the airport welcomed news.
We're waiting for like an hour and then we just hear people saying on the phone like, oh, like, have you heard the news? You don't have to anymore.
So yeah. And then everyone just fled.
The exodus allowed others to take advantage of the short wait times.
Paid a few extra bucks at car parking and save a couple of hours of time.
Interstate travellers still require a negative test within 72 hours before they arrive.
With the 4,700 tests on Sunday, I think it was, for those people coming in from Victoria, there was less than a 1 in 1,000 chance that was going to be a positive case.
But once we started to have more cases in our own state, then really our focus is on those people that have symptoms here in South Australia.
SA Pathology is recruiting more staff to help deal with the soaring demand.
Increase the number of resources to make existing clinics 24/7 that aren't, and reopen the clinics that the Marshall Liberal government has closed in terms of testing.
The emergence of Omicron has now dated the forecasts made a few months ago, predicting how COVID would develop in SA.
Well, the modelling evolves over time, Alan. It's a very good question, and this is one of the reasons why I'm very keen to get to the National Cabinet tomorrow.
The government is urging people to book online tests to reduce waiting times. Alan Murrell, 4 News First.